so next we have to study is about the statement of profit and loss. Okay, next heading is about the statement of profit and loss. Statement of profit and loss is a part of a financial statement that depicts the financial performance of a company by showing net results, profit and or loss suffered during the accounting period. It shows revenue from operations, other incomes, total revenue, expenses and profit before and after tax. Statement of profit and loss of a company shall give a true and fair view of the profit or a loss of a company for the financial year and shall comply with the requirements of part 2 of schedule 3 of the Companies Act 2013. Statement of profit and loss is a summary of financial performance of a company over a particular period of time, as it represents a report stating income for a period and subtract expenses incurred for the same period to determine profit and loss of the business. So like there are, say, like if a company is doing the transaction, the company is making so much amount of revenue is there, you know, income generated, and at the same time company is having expenses also. You know, see, like when a product is sold, imagine that if a product we are selling, like if a biscuit is there, 10 rupees biscuit, if we are selling, if we are a wholesaler, if I am a wholesale shop, and if I have a 10 rupees biscuit is sold, so the 10 rupees is the income that I am getting. But at the same time, I have expenses also, because if I have purchased this product from a wholesale market, wholesale shop, and I might have purchased, I have to pay 7-8 rupees there. Okay, so there is a additional 2 rupees is there. So we cannot we can say it is as a gross profit, but we cannot fully say that this is the gross profit. You know, so we have other expenses also. We may have transportation cost will be there. We have storage cost will be there. You know, so some so many other expenditures are there. So we have to reduce the amount of this. So we may have to pay some taxes, some other payments we will have to pay. All these type of things have to be included, then only we can exactly find out what is the actual amount of profit or a loss. Okay, even though when you say like a gross amount may be profit, but adding all together, we may be considering that the real situation of the company may be in loss. Okay, so that can be understood by the statement of profit and loss account. Okay, so now let us study how to prepare this one, preparation of the statement of profit and loss account. The part 2 of the Schedule 3 of Companies Act 2013 has prescribed a format for presenting the information about the profit earned or loss suffered. So the format is given there. You can see, just you can see the picture there, no? Okay. So the format of a profit and loss account, on the top there is like a name of the company, statement of profit and loss account for the year ended. So that name will be written on the top. And there are different particulars are there, like revenue from operations, other incomes, total revenue, expenses. Not there in your book? Is it there in your book?
Yes, sir.
It is already shown, no? You don't have book? Okay. So all these type of things are shown in that. Okay. So there is a different particulars are there. So let us now we will study about different parts. Like when we studied about balance sheet, we studied that what are the different parts of that. So same way we will study about different contents or what are the different points included in this one. So first one is from the revenue from operations. The first point, when you see that picture, you can see number one is given, revenue from operations. You know, the first point is given. So revenue from operations. Under this header, all the revenue earned by the entity only through the prime business operations are recorded. For a manufacturing and trading concern, the revenue from operations is derived from the activities specified below, like sales of product, sales of services, other operating revenues, nature to be specified, like and less discounts, allowance, returns and excise duty. So see, like when a company's main income, source of income, main whatever the revenue that the company is making by the, it's the main activities. Okay, see, like if a company, so like the prime business operations, the most important activities or the major activities of the company. Okay, see, like if a company is like a wholesale company, then selling of the product is the main activity of the company. Okay, so by selling the product, what income is generated, that is their main source of income. Okay, if it is a service providing company, by providing the service, what amount that they are getting, that is their main source of income. Okay, and for any entity providing financial services or a finance company, revenue from operations consists of revenue derived from the following, like interest, dividend, and other financial services. So like if it is like a bank or any financial company like that, so such kind of a companies are there, then for them the main source of income is there, interest and dividends. Do you understand? So whatever may be the type of company, in that company, the what is their major activity, the prime business operations, most, the what is the main purpose of the business, and by how much the company is making income by doing that activity. See, like for a school, so the school is the prime activity is teaching by educational methods, how much income the school can be generated, that is the main source of income. So only by school the like a fees is generated, and the students' fees is there, only that is the source of income. We don't have any other source of income, you know. And if like a wholesale shop is there, or whatever maybe the shops are there, so by selling the products, what income that they are generating, that is the prime source of income. Okay, then do you understand? First one, revenue from operation is there. Then next one is other incomes. Second heading is other incomes. Other incomes represents the revenue earned by an entity through its ancillary activities of investment and others that are apart from the primary business operations. In other words, other incomes include income earned from non-operating activities of a business. This component shall include the following items, like interest income in case of entities other than finance, dividend income or rental on investment properties, increase or decrease in carrying amounts of investments, net gain or loss on sale of investment. Other incomes means that the income which is not included in the prime operations of a business. Okay, so like if what is the main objective of a business, like selling a product is the prime objective, and by selling objective, selling the product, how much profit the company is making, other than that, if any income is there, that will come in the other incomes. Okay, see, like if a company is having, imagine that if a company is having a roof and a company or a building is there, and now we are not using that building, so we are giving this building for rent and we are getting a rent from there, so that is not the main purpose of the, now we don't use it, so we have given it for rent and we get some interest for it. Or if like some capital amount is there, and that capital we are investing in some other functions, other activities, so that interest we are getting. Or we purchase that, like we have some money and we are investing some money for purchasing some shares, okay, and some dividend we got from that, so that is also, so such kind of, see, like some companies, they purchase the shares of other companies, so by using as a source of investment they make this one, so like that if they get any dividend or any income. Or then increase or decrease in carrying amounts of investments, like if you make an investments and in that if an increase or decrease is taking place, so variation in that. Or any net gain or loss on investments, like if we are selling any assets, or if we like by investing, if you get any more profits, all these type of things will come in the category of other income. So everything that is included other than the prime operation, prime business operations, whatever the main function of the organization will come in the first heading. If any other income is there, that will come in the other incomes. Do you understand? Okay. Then next is about the expenses. So only that is the income part. So in that, under that there is like a total revenue. Then next point is a total revenue will be there. In the total revenue, we will add income, revenue from operations and other income. Both will be added. Number 1 and 2, that will be added, and we write the total revenue. So there is in this, there are two columns are given. So figures for the current reporting year period and figures for the previous reporting year period. Now, this year how much profit, see like the how much revenue is there, and how much other income is there, and how much total income is there, that will be written in the first column. And last year how much was the income, and how much other income was there, and how much the total revenue will be there, that will be recorded in the last column. Understood? Then next, so that much only the revenue is there, income part is there. Second section we have to write is about the expenses, fourth point. Okay. These refers to the cost directly associated with the producing revenues and include the following terms like cost of material consumed. So first one is that we will be purchasing raw materials, isn't it? No? So the purchase of raw materials, so for that how much money is spent, that will be there first one. These costs refers to the raw materials and the other materials utilized in the production process of various manufacturing concerns. The most of the materials consumed can be arrived by adding the net purchases to opening balance of inventory and deducting the closing balance from the sum. So the total three activities are there. So for calculation of the net purchases, the following calculation will be done. Like gross purchases, total amount of purchases will be there, and if any returns are there, that will be deducted. Okay, gross purchase less returns. Then any discounts are there, that will be deducted. Any allowances are provided, that will be deducted. And freight inwards and net purchases, all this we will be calculating, and at last we will be getting the net purchases. So gross purchase will be there, means total amount of how many purchases we have made, that will be returned. And from that we will reduce the returns, any return product is there. So like your purchases, if you have returned, purchases returns are there, that we have to reduce. Any discount is there, that we have to reduce. Any allowances or any freight inwards, any like a transportation cost is added, all these things we have to reduce. Understood? And the remaining money that we get is called as a net purchase. Okay? But this net purchase will not be directly entered there, but again we have to see like opening balance of inventory of material. Like we will see like in the, like if for this year we are calculating, so previous year some raw materials leftover will be there. So that we will be adding. So opening balance of the inventory plus add net purchases. Okay, so like net purchases in this year's total purchases we will calculate, and with the previous year we will add it. Okay. Then less closing balance of inventory of materials. Okay, so last year, imagine that if some 200 rupees, this one is there. Okay. So if 200 rupees assets are their previous balance, and this year we have made a purchase of 5,000 rupees, 2,000 rupees opening balance is there, some 5,000 rupees net purchase we made in this year, so total it became 7,000, is it not? And in that, for there is a closing stock is there of 3,000 rupees value of assets are there as a closing stock. So that we will reduce. So total we will get 4,000 rupees. 4,000 rupees of products are used for the current year. Do you understand? Previous year 2,000 was there. Then net purchase we will add with that. So total we will get 2,000 was there. So plus 5,000, total we will get 7,000. Then from there we will reduce the closing stock. Then we get the remaining money, remaining amount that is used for the current year. Do you understand? Then next one is purchases of stock in trade. This refers to the stock of goods purchased by trading companies with the purpose of resale later. Okay, see like if any raw materials or any goods are purchased for the purpose of resale, so those will be there. So any stock we have purchased and for the purpose of reselling, we are not producing anything, we like wholesale shops or retail shops and all, they are purchasing the product and for the purpose of resale they are using it. So those stock will be added in that. Then next one, changes in the inventories of finished goods, work in progress and stock in trade. This represents the difference in the opening and closing balance of inventories of finished goods, work in progress and stock in trade. In notes to accounts, change in inventories of each item shown separately, and a change in inventory is added to show one amount in a statement of a profit and loss account. So see like we will be adding these three things are there, like work in progress, finished goods are there. If any finished goods after completing the products, how much amount of finished goods are there, that will be their stock we will have. So that stock will be there, and opening stock will be there. Difference between opening stock and closing stock will be there. Okay. Then work in progress, if any products which are producing on the way, we have not completed. We started the production, but could not complete it. So that will be coming in the category of work in progress. So that also opening stock and closing stock variation will be there. That will be considered. Then stock in trade. So for the purpose of selling, if you have brought something that we are also, that also stock will be there. So all these three things, opening stock and closing stock separately will be there. So when you show notes to accounts, we have to show it in separately, but all these three things together we will show in the profit and loss account. Then next one, employees benefit expenses. This refers to all expenditure incurred by an entity for employees of the company. Thus, it includes all direct and indirect labor expenses. It includes the following items like, see, employees benefit expenses means that like salary will be there, you know. So like some workers will be there, their salary has to be paid. Some salary means the, if an employee is working regularly, continuous, if like monthly salary will be there for regular employees. And there will be some daily wages employees are there, you know. So they are, how many days they come based on that day, like laborers and all, their charges will be calculated as a daily wages like. Then bonus and leave encashment, if any bonus is to be provided or any leave, leave is not taken. See, like in a month, if an employee is having 5 days of leave, and if 5 days of leave if he has not taken, then for that company will pay an additional money. Okay. Then staff welfare expenses. So for staff welfare, for the welfare of the staff, there will be spending some money like making some providing some tea, coffee, or any other type of activities will be conducted, or get together, birthday celebration of the employees. Okay, all these type of expenditures will be there. So all that spend for the staff welfare expenses. Okay, so maintaining, or sometimes for the employees they will be providing some gift and all, you know. So some birthday celebration may be conducted, and some gift is provided to the employees from the side of the company in order to motivate the employees. So such a kind of things are there. Or if like a best performer or those who are doing achieving some additional benefits, so for them any programs may be done. So all these are there. Then employees contribution to the provident fund and other schemes. And if in a company, if an employee is working, so for an employee, see, like if his salary is there, and out of this one particular percentage of the salary is provided as kept in the company as a provident fund. Okay, so if an employee is getting like 20,000 rupees as his total income, in that 2,000 rupees will be given or deposited into the provident fund. So if 2000 rupees is to be deducted from his 2000 rupees is deducted from the salary of the employee, and that will be deposited, and the 2000 rupees additional from the company also has to be paid into the provident fund. Okay, so total amount of salary actually will be of 22,000, you know. So total 4000 rupees has to be paid into the provident fund. The employee will receive only 18,000, but 4,000 rupees additional means 2,000 rupees of the employee which he is deducted, and 2,000 rupees from the company side also has to be paid into the provident fund. Then employees state insurance. So there is like a company will be taking insurance for the employees, all the employees together. So that insurance premium has to be paid, for that will be there. Or gratuity payments and employees contribution to gratuity fund. So there will be like a gratuity amount also. So when an employee is leaving the organization, then a gratuity is paid. So gratuity means the amount, see, like imagine that if I am working in a company for 10 years, okay, and at the time of closure, if I am getting 50,000, 60,000 rupees is my salary if I am receiving when I am closing, when I am leaving, when I am getting retired. So 60,000 rupees is there. Then 50% of that means 30,000 into 10 years. If I am working for 10 years, 30,000 into 10 years, 3 lakh rupees, I will get as a gratuity amount. Okay. So that amount is, in that also some amount is collected from the already when he is gratuity fund, we are collecting from the salary, deducting from the salary of the employee, and depositing this money to the salary account of or the, into the gratuity account. And some half portion of that is taken by the company. Companies also will be paying that. So that contribution of the company will be there. So that will be also another expenditure. Okay, so these are the expenditures which we are paying for the employees. Then next expenditure is a finance cost. Such cost refers to the expense borne by an entity on various borrowings undertaken by it for varied business purposes. It is classified into three items enumerated as follows. Interest expense on various borrowings. So if you have taken, like company has taken some borrowed funds are there, so then interest has to be paid. You know, bank loan is there, or dividend will be there, or any bank loan or some bonds are taken, or debentures are there, all these type of things are there. So for that we have to pay the interest. So that interest has to be paid. So that interest will be there, interest on various borrowings. Other borrowing cost, expenses incurred for borrowing, such as discount on issue of debentures, loan processing fee, etc. So for taking this loan also we have to pay some money, you know. Like imagine that if you are taking a bank loan, then a bank loan for applying for bank loan, we have to pay some paper charges, office expenses, like that some cost will be there. Okay, all these cost will be coming as a other borrowing cost. And net gain or loss incurred on foreign currency transactions and translations. Okay, see, like imagine that, see, like if we are dealing with foreign countries, like if multinational companies and all are there. So if we are supplying products to other company, or if companies are bringing products, raw materials are brought from other company, other country, then the transactions are made with a foreign currency, you know. So when there is a transaction made, there will be if we make the transaction now, and we make the transaction now, we fix it for a particular price, but that price may be sent after some time. Okay, so by that time the price of the every day the value of the currencies are decreasing or increasing, mostly increasing, isn't it? So there is a fluctuation in that price, so slight variation will be there. So that, and when the companies are dealing with a huge amounts, so that is 0.5 or 5 paise, 10 paise difference will be there. That will be a very huge amount. So that type of variations will be there. So sometimes it will be net gain, or if we get a profit, or if we face loss by doing all the transactions, that will be also added. These are the three finance cost. The next cost is depreciation expenses. This refers to a fixed amount of tangible fixed assets that is written off over their useful life. So depreciation you have already studied, you know. So different assets are there, and all the assets are having depreciation. So we calculate the value of depreciation, and this money will be written off from the value of the assets. So that is kind of another expense. Then amortization expenses. This refers to the amount of intangible fixed assets that is written off over a period of time. For example, goodwill, preliminary expenses, technical know-how, patents, etc. So sometimes depreciation means the amount of depreciation that we have calculated for fixed assets. And amortization expenses means that sometimes if goodwill and all is there, so that if it is after many years, then we will be writing off. Okay, so the value of this, if the company's reputation has come down, or any patent we have taken but now we are not using, or any such kind of things are there, so that will be written off. So when we write off these things, these amortization expenses will be taking place. And other expenses, if other than these any expenses are there, that will come as other expenses. These expenses refers to the disbursals of expenses that cannot be included in any of the categories listed above. For example, selling and marketing expenses, administrative expenses, advertising, commission payable, bank charges, bad debts, fee paid to the advisory, auditors, advisors, insurance expenses, utilities like water and electricity expenses, etc. So if any of the expenses which cannot be coming in any of these categories, that will be coming under the category of other expenses. So if main categories are already given, and if it is of that category, that will be included in those category, and if it is not coming in any of these category, that will be added in the other expenses. Okay, so these are the different expenses. So we can say one example, one problem we can do. can write down this one. Cost of materials consumed. Okay, cost of materials consumed. Calculate cost of materials consumed from the following information. Okay, calculate cost of material consumed from the following information. First, you can write opening inventory of materials. Then next, materials purchased. That is the plan. The next one, closing inventory of materials. So, how to calculate cost of materials consumed?
Opening plus this
purchase minus closing. Calculate. How much is coming? Okay. So how it is calculated? First, these two have to be added. This one, both of this has to be added. Then you have minus this one. So when you add this one, 5,62,500 will come. Then you have to reduce 75,000 from there. So the answer will be
4,87,500.
Okay. This is a simple calculation. Then, one more question I can give you. Calculation of employees' benefit expenses of X Limited. Okay. Calculate employees' benefit expenses. Okay. X Limited made the following payments to its employees during the year ended 31st March 2018. X Limited made the following payments to its employees during the year ended 31st March 2018. So the expenses are there. First one, wages. That is a 5,10,000. Then second one, salaries. That is a 7,60,000. Okay, so these are the expenses. So you have to prepare notes to account for on employees benefit expenses. You have to prepare notes to account for employees benefit expenses. So you have to make your notes to account there only that particular this format is there. What do you have to do? You have to add, is it not?
Yes.
All the things will come. What are the things will not come?
Leave
and cash. Leave will not come.
No, sir.
It will come. Which one?
Wages.
Wages will come. Salary of the employee. If an employee is getting 60,000 as his employee, salary now. Now he is adding 60,000 is the salary. Then 50% of that, 30,000. Okay? Into the number of years that he worked. So if he worked for 10 years, then the 3 lakh rupees will be. So that 3 lakh will be paid to the person. So for that, when he is working, a gratuity, for gratuity, some money is deducted from the salary. So that will not be shown, but that money is already deducted. And the remaining money, so like if total 3 lakh rupees is to be given, in that so like around 1 lakh rupees will be already deducted from the salary account of the employee, and the remaining 2 lakh will be paid by the company. And for this one, there are different methods used. Okay, so it's like a private, these are the common rules used by the government or the common companies. So government companies may have different rules, and private companies have got different rules. It depends on, but a gratuity means any money paid at the time of retirement. So if an employee is retiring, or if he is leaving the company and going. Okay, now in between, so like if I work here for 10 years, and after that I am going to Kerala for continuing my work there, then if I am leaving and going, then the school will pay me a whole amount. Then the school will be calculating maybe in a different way, or they will say like there some 2 lakh rupees as given, this is the contribution as your service, like that they will give one money.